Using more complicated series parallel networks of switches, we can build devices that implement more complex logic functions. To design a more complex logic gate, first figure the series and parallel connections of PFET switches that will connect the gate's output to VDD for the right combination of inputs. In this example, the output F will be 1 when A is 0 or when both B is 0 and C is 0. The OR translates into a parallel connection, and the AND translates into a series connection, giving the pull-up circuit you see to the right. To build the complementary pull-down circuit, systematically walk the hierarchy of pull-up connections, replacing PFETs with NFETs, series subcircuits with parallel subcircuits, and parallel subcircuits with series subcircuits. In the example shown, the pull-up circuit had a switch controlled by A in parallel with a series subcircuit consisting of switches controlled by B and C. The complementary pull-down circuit uses NFETs with a switch controlled by A in series with a parallel subcircuit consisting of switches controlled by B and C. Finally, combine the pull-up and pull-down circuits to form a fully complementary CMOS implementation. This probably went by quickly, but with practice you'll get comfortable with the CMOS design process. Mr. Blue is asking a good question. Will this recipe work for any and all logic functions? The answer is no. Let's see why. Using CMOS, a single gate, a circuit with one pull-up network and one pull-down network, can only implement the so-called inverting functions, where rising inputs lead to falling outputs, and vice versa. To see why, consider what happens when one of the gate's inputs goes from 0 to 1. Any NFET switches controlled by the rising input will go from off to on. This may enable one or more paths between the gate's output and ground. And PFET switches controlled by the rising input will go from on to off. This may disable one or more paths between the gate's output and VDD. So if the gate's output changes as a result of the rising input, it must be because some pull-down path was enabled and some pull-up path was disabled. In other words, any change in the output voltage due to a rising input must be a falling transition from 1 to 0. Similar reasoning tells us that falling inputs must lead to rising outputs. In fact, for any non-constant CMOS gate, we know that its output must be 1 when all inputs are 0, since all the NFETs are off and all the PFETs are on, and vice versa. If all the inputs are 1, the gate's output must be 0. This means that so-called positive logic can't be implemented with a single CMOS gate. Look at this truth table for the AND function. Its value when both inputs are 0 or both inputs are 1 is inconsistent with our deductions about the output of a CMOS gate for these combinations of inputs. Furthermore, we can see that when A is 1 and B rises from 0 to 1, the output rises instead of falls. Moral of the story? When you're a CMOS designer, you'll get very good at implementing functionality with inverting logic.